Hi! Welcome to this demo of SharePA, a new SharePoint automation framework developed by Aloha. Today, we are going to show you how we automate document-related workflows and manage their life cycles, while we improve transparency within the organization. We will drive a document through its key milestones using workflows. For the demo, we will use this online site, which mainly contains quality document management features and some quality data modules. Let's take a look at the document library where we can manage and share documents. There is a modification in the user interface. We designed a new ribbon where a useful set of tools has been created and we can perform, among other features, workflow-related operations. You can easily and safely automate your workflows such as approval or publication. In this demo, first, we prepare our document to become a real resident of our automated environment. As we move forward, we'll get it approved and publish it. We will handle a change request and extend its validity before its expiry. Finally, we cover an expiry and archiving automation. Let's see how a document starts its life in our system. We can use an existing document or start with prepared company templates. This time, let's start with a brand new, empty document. I drop it into the library from my desktop. After this action, we need to enter all necessary data for our new document, which enables it to be part of the automated environment. The predefined document types exactly determine what data we have to provide to the system. Different document categories may request different sets of data and actors. We fill in the necessary data and also assign users or user groups to roles. This will be important during the user-attended workflows. We have properly placed our document into the document management system and attached the necessary metadata. Our document automatically received a version number, currently 0.1, an ID, and the state. All set. From now, it's a draft. While Jules working on his document, I would like to show you our document approval process in the workflow editor. Using this graphical tool, it's easy to create, edit, and maintain our workflows. As you can see, this workflow includes review and approval steps. The approver can send the document back for revision, decline, or approve it. Let's check out who's going to judge our work. Vincent is going to review and Marcellus is our approver. All right, it's time to get it approved then. Launching the process is a super easy task. Just select the document and the workflow you would like to run and click on it. Vincent has just received a message from the system that a task has been created. The link will take him directly to a section that was designed to perform user-attended tasks. Vincent is satisfied with the content and recommends approval. As soon as he presses the Done button, the workflow enters its next phase. The document state has been changed to Under Approval. Let's switch to the view of Marcellus, who has a decision to make today. This time we approach the task manager from the application. Let's select the task and execute it. The task form can provide a lot of useful information related to your assignment. You can also open the document for your evaluation directly from the page. Marcellus takes Vincent's opinion into account, finds it good, and approves it. Well done! We have an approved document. Let's publish it quickly. We select the approved document and start the publishing process, which sets up which users or groups can access the document, converts it to PDF format, copies it to the published documents directory, sets the state to published, notify the stakeholders, and increase the version number. This workflow will complete quickly, as there's no user step involved. Our document can fulfill its essential role of providing information to its readers. Mia seems to have found a non-conformity in the content that needs to be corrected. Such cases should be subject to a change request process. This workflow is very similar to the approval process, except that it can be initiated by readers. During the process, the first task is given to the user who initiates the change. She can justify her request and may suggest a solution. The document owner can then decide whether the request is relevant, and if so, the responsible person can make the change. From this point, the procedure is the same as the approval workflow. Our team works just great with SharePA. They already finished the change of the document, and Jules, the document owner, has already started the publishing workflow, which will do the job in no time. That's right, as you can see, our content is up to date again. Later, a month before its validity ends, an automated workflow will guide it through a review, which may extend its validity for the next time period. In case the document expires, another automatic mechanism carefully removes it from the published documents and ensures that it is treated in accordance with company regulations. The archiving process is handled by a scheduled workflow in this setup. The workflow history is easily accessible from the ribbon. Let's see what has happened to our document since its birth. The complete lifecycle history of our documents is easily available. Well done! In a few minutes, we went through the basic functionality of automated document management. We have all the tools to suit your SharePoint environment to your company's specific requirements and processes, to save valuable time, increase transparency, and achieve a better user experience. As you have seen, SharePA was natively and deeply integrated into your SharePoint environment. It works like a plugin, and you can connect your business-related data sources, application, or service to make a step forward in your digital transformation journey. So, if you are ready to start transforming your SharePoint-based environment into an automated workspace, register for a free, personalized demo or consultation at sharepa.io today.